Some breaking news are coming in from the national capital. The Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, in a Twitter post, questioned how the LG is representing the Delhi government at the Niti Aayog meeting. Kejriwal tweeted that no provision under the constitution allowed the LG to replace the chief minister. He also added that he had not authorized the LG as his replacement. Well, there is more drama in the making in the national capital as the Delhi police has now denied permission for the Aam Aadmi Party protest march, which was scheduled to take place this evening. In fact, four of the metro stations nearby Prime Minister residence will be kept shut during that time. In fact, the AAP workers will be detained in case of any violation. Meanwhile, the latest to jump onto the anti-centre bandwagon is the DMK's working president Stalin. Remember, on Saturday, it was a massive show of unity behind Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, the Chief Minister of four non-BJP states, Mamata Banerjee, Chandrababu Naidu, H.D. Kumaraswamy and Pinarayi Vijayan, urged the centre to end this entire deadlock. Going across to Aishwarya now for further details and perspective on this ongoing deadlock that has been continuing. Aishwarya, first and foremost, the tweet that has now come out from Arvind Kejriwal again locking horns with the LG, saying that he hasn't given any authorization for the LG to attend the meeting and he cannot be representing Delhi on his behalf.
Well, definitely, Apoorva, the tweet you were talking about, it reads that under which provision of the constitution does LG have powers to replace the chief minister? I have not authorized him to go in my place. So definitely, as you rightly pointed out, this is Arvind Kejriwal, the chief minister of New Delhi, locking horns with the LG. And also asking him who gave him the permission to go to the Niti Aayog. So definitely, we can see that both the parties are maintaining their stand very firmly. Arvind Kejriwal and his ministers have plonked themselves at the LG house, refusing to budge, refusing to step out till the time LG bows down to their demands. The LG, on the other hand, has held meetings with ministers. We saw how when Delhi was facing severe pollution crisis, that time the LG had called a meeting and he had also passed orders. So definitely the LG, they are going about his work as if nothing has happened. The chief minister and his ministers there, you know, plonking themselves. And right now the Niti Aayog meeting that we are talking about, I'm standing right outside the Niti Aayog Bhavan. A very crucial meeting is being held inside, where the Prime Minister is also a part of this meeting. Now the four chief ministers who held a press conference yesterday, they are a part of this meeting. And very categorically, Mamata Banerjee, the Chief Minister of West Bengal, had said yesterday that all four of them would be putting pressure on the Prime Minister, in whichever way they can. And then also requesting him to intervene in this matter, because now they are saying that democracy is under threat, and they also showed a lot of solidarity with what Arvind Kejriwal is demanding.
Absolutely, Aishwarya. On one hand, where we are seeing a direct face-off yet again between the Delhi Chief Minister and LG over representation at the Niti Aayog. On the other hand, we will be witnessing some more drama in the national capital. This as far as the Aam Aadmi Party workers who are planning to march to the Prime Minister's office, the permission there being denied. What are the sources telling you? Are they still going to go ahead with the march?
Well, definitely, though, there's nothing that will stop AAP supporters and AAP ministers from going ahead with the march. However, now permission has been denied, and we could get a sense of them being denied permission yesterday itself when we saw heavy barricading around the LG's house when news was there that all the four chief ministers were wanting to go and meet Arvind Kejriwal. At that point also, let me remind you, the LG had refused to give permission to all the four chief ministers, and this was something that was reiterated by Mamata Banerjee very forcefully in the press conference. She said that we had asked for permission. We had written a letter to the LG seeking permission to go and visit Arvind Kejriwal, but he had denied permission. So definitely we were expecting the police to deny permission to AAP leaders in this march also, but the march will take place as scheduled.
Also, Aishwarya, you were there in the yesterday press conference, a significant press conference of sorts, where all the four chief ministers categorically slamming the LG for not being able to resolve this issue in a timely manner. The kind of support that is really pouring in is also very interesting, with a lot of people going ahead and looking at it as something that perhaps could be very beneficial for the 2019 elections.
Well, definitely everything is extremely significant if you keep the next general elections in mind. We have seen support pouring in for the Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, not just in the form of these four chief ministers, but we also saw Kamal Hassan tweeting and showing his unity and extending his support to Arvind Kejriwal. Not just that, we also saw how M.K. Stalin also tweeted after the press conference being held by these four chief ministers. He's saying that what Arvind Kejriwal is asking for is right. So we are seeing from all the quarters support now being extended to Arvind Kejriwal. This is not just a Delhi issue now. This is not just a fight between Arvind Kejriwal and the LG. It has now got the attention of chief ministers from across our country. And this is something which has been going on for some time now, Apoorva. We have seen how our ministers for quite some time have been raising this issue, and they have been talking about how files are stuck, projects are stalled. They're also saying that the project, important projects for our government, like Mohalla clinics, important projects like polyclinics, also door-to-door delivery of ration, these are important issues for the AAP government. All of them are stuck. So we have seen how this is a culmination of months and months of ministers highlighting these issues. We have seen time and again how Manish Sisodia and also Satyendra Jain talk about how the bureaucracy and especially the LG is stalling these important projects.
Okay. All right, Aishwarya, stay with us. We are getting some fresh reaction also coming in from the Aam Aadmi Party. Let's listen in.
We will be carrying out the march. We will be doing the gherao of the Prime Minister's residence. We want our voices to be heard, and the Prime Minister, who's aware of all the developments but is choosing not to respond or intervene and letting this political crisis grow bigger and bigger, must realize that the people of Delhi are against him. The people of Delhi are against the BJP, and the people of Delhi are with that person who is fighting for the rights of the people of Delhi. This march is very important, very significant. We will go on with the march irrespective of the permission. We will certainly, and I've been told that thousands and thousands of people from all over Delhi, different parts of Delhi, different constituencies of Delhi, are coming at 4 p.m. for the historic march.
Going across to Aishwarya now, we just heard Raghav Chadda of the Aam Aadmi Party very clearly saying that there is no way they are going to stop this march. They will be going ahead. Clearly, there is going to be a lot of drama, with the police very categorically saying that all the metro stations, the four metro stations being shut, they will be detained if they go ahead and violate the prohibitory orders.
Well, we can expect a lot of drama, and we have been seeing a lot of drama taking place, Apoorva, in the national capital for the past 1 week. You know, it started with Arvind Kejriwal, Manish Sisodia and Satyendra Jain going and plonking themselves at the LG house, refusing to budge, saying they will not move till the time the LG bows down to what they have to say, till the time the LG agrees to their demands. We also saw how Arvind Kejriwal wrote to the Prime Minister when the pollution levels in Delhi were in the hazardous category. He had asked the Prime Minister to intervene, though we haven't seen any kind of intervention taking place yet. We also know that Sanjay Singh, Sanjay Singh of Aam Aadmi Party went to meet the Home Minister Rajnath Singh. The meeting lasted barely 15 minutes. But after that, Sanjay Singh came out and said that Rajnath Singh has assured him that he will look into this matter and he'll make sure that the deadlock gets resolved very soon. So a lot of talks there. But you know, if you see on the ground, then both of them, the LG as well as the Aam Aadmi Party, the chief minister, are standing extremely firm on their grounds, refusing to budge till the time demands are met.
All right, Aishwarya, stay with us. Some more interesting reactions there coming in. On one hand, the Aam Aadmi Party has clearly said that they are not going to bow down. They will continue this protest. Let's find out what opposition parties like the NCP are now looking at this development.
Duly elected chief minister is being treated worse than a common man, because access to lieutenant governor has been denied, because lieutenant government is an instrument of center and is dancing at their tunes, which is very unfortunate. In fact, under the Indian democracy, it is the chief minister who should have an upper hand over the lieutenant governor. But Delhi is an exception. And we have seen that almost for 4 or 5 days, the entire cabinet, chief minister, deputy chief minister, are all at the doors of LG, but nobody is bothered to break the deadlock. The center has looked the other way. All concerned from the center, there are absolutely no instructions to budge.